What's up, Buster?
We'll be right back.
Looking pretty good. That's the good side. It's even dirtier on this side. Lots to do. Let's keep at it. Kind of see some more of the rust issues. The hood's pretty much toast. But the cab is in good shape. Don't see any rust issues up here. It was protected by the camper, so that's awesome. There is some rust down in the fender there. A little bit here and there, but we're gonna get it all cleaned up. We'll take a closer look at the inside of the cab and the inside of the camper at some point, but I want to get all of the algae and mildew and dirt off of it, let it bake out in the sun, and just get it nice and clean inside and out, and then we'll do a first start video on it. All right, guys, let's see if we can get some more of this stuff off of here. All right, check it out. It's starting to look pretty good. Let's take a closer look at the roof here, guys. Might be some wind. It's pretty windy out here. Sorry about that. It's a little squirrely up here. You get up here and the whole camper starts to shake. It's a little scary. But yeah. This piece was broken off. There was already some water getting in there. We're just gonna have to rinse it really good. And you know, obviously there's water that's gotten inside the camper. I don't know if we can save it. I mean, you can save anything. It's just a matter of how much money you want to put into it, time. But we might be able to just clean it really good and replace some of the rotten wood around here. Who knows? It might be too far gone, but it's getting there. Old Swamp Drag is looking pretty good. Let's see what's under the hood. Oh, it's got some sharp teeth. Oh. 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 Wow. Wow. Looking pretty rough in here, guys. Well, we might have to save that for another day. Look at that vice grip. That's awesome. I don't think I've seen a vice grip that rusty. Oh yeah, it's nice when the clouds are covering the sun, boy. It gets hot out here. What do you think? You think we should give the old boy a bath? A lot of dirt, leaves, dirt, all kinds of junk in there, boy. Let's see if we can get this. Definitely gonna need to clean this up before we try to start it. It's really messy. We're gonna clean all this stuff out of here, change the oil, put some Marvel Mystery oil down the spark plug holes, let it soak for a few days. But I think we can cover the carburetor with a bag, maybe the coil. and maybe the alternator, and just spray pressure wash the heck out of this, I think we'll be all right. We're gonna drain the oil anyway, and we're gonna flush out the system, so we should be fine to spray this down. That old carburetor. All right, let me cover that carburetor up real quick. What could go wrong? All right, guys, let's get this mess out of here so we can work on it, get it running again. Pretty bad. It's real bad, so. And hit it with the pressure washer, and hopefully we can make it not so bad. Let's see what the oil looks like.
Well, usually the oil floats on top of the water. So you can check the oil. Smells good, it doesn't smell gassy. But it's hard to tell if there's any water in there until you pull the plug. The oil will float on top of the water. So if there's any water in it, it'll be at the drain plug. And we'll find that out when we pull the drain plug.
Yeah.
But the oil smells good and feels good.
Well, that's good.
But, you never know. With that much rust in the breather like that, it's kind of disturbing. There's clearly water was making it through that old rusty hood and into the breather.
Yeah.
It's almost rusted through.
Yeah, it's been sitting there for a while. Look at the bottom of the filter.
It doesn't look like water was standing here, so maybe it's not, hopefully it's not in the motor. Because that will be a deal killer.
So we just finished pressure washing the truck and pressure washed the engine bay a little bit, and we opened up the breather and noticed there's some rust in there. The hood is pretty rusted out. So we're gonna pull the plugs, put some Marvel mystery oil down in there, drain the oil, and start getting ready to do a first start on it.
If it's not locked up.
If it's not locked up. Hopefully it's not.
Cleaned up pretty nice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and there's still a lot to do. I'm sure the bed's pretty nasty and the inside of the camper is pretty bad.
This radiator support is rotted out bad. Bottom of it's rusted out. Gone.
Can you get a new one of those?
Yeah, we can replace that. It's not that difficult. But the important thing would be if you can get the motor to turn over.
Yeah. Well, I guess we'll have to, once we get some mystery oil down the plugs and drain the oil, see if it'll turn over, put a battery in it.
It all looks factory, all original hoses. It really looks factory to me.
You don't see any modifications anywhere?
No, this is just how it came to.
What's that right there?
I don't know. Looks like it goes to the automatic choke. Yeah, so that's the heat tube that brings the hot gas from the exhaust manifold up to the diaphragm on the automatic choke. Once the engine warms up, the choke opens automatically.
Which you don't really need too much here in Florida, right?
Well, some motors are cold natured and take a little while to warm up, even on a mild morning. So some engines don't need it, some do.
Does this look like the factory paint?
Yeah, that's factory. That's never been. Sticker assembly line. A lot of water leaking in here. Rats have been chewing on the electrical harness. See that? Got the insulation chewed and
rats chewing on it?
Rats and squirrels would get in there and do that. But that wire's been chewed completely through. And almost that one. Yeah, they like the taste of vacuum hoses and insulation on the wiring harness.
This is a 390, right?
It's supposed to be. I haven't looked at the numbers yet, but that's what it's supposed to be. Battery tray is gone.
Oh yeah, it's rusted out.
Inner fender's gone. Rot. Well, did you clean the interior yet? No.
No, interior is going to be another day. Interior, I'll do the interior cab maybe, and back of the camper.
Let's just see what that bed looks like.
I know.
See how well it was protected from this camper.
Yeah.
We dragged that off another day.
Yep. We got something we can set it on?
Yeah, we can set it. Getting a hold of it without destroying it is going to be the challenge. All the wood in here is rotted. These jacks are attached to it.
Yeah. That doesn't look right. It's a little wobbly. Yeah. I was standing up on top of it and it was rocking back and forth a little bit.
You'll probably destroy the camper, get it off.
What's up, Buster?
Ammonia refrigerator.
Oh wow.
This is probably a gas refrigerator. No, that's what a gas propane bottle says.
Hot water.
Do the hot water
and stove.
The cool rotted out, so they're not going to support anything.
Right.
This could get them to move.
Well, it'd be cool if we could save it, but it's probably going to get destroyed taking it off, like you said.
Rotted from the inside out.